now, Mark Hanna, a Democratic analyst and a veteran of two presidential campaigns.
Mark Hanna, Democratic political analyst.
What are the talking points, Mark? Listen, Larry, I don't have any talking points because I came in and ready to answer your questions directly. And I want to address what Grace Marie said very directly.
This country has had a long legacy of an oppositional, adversarial press that's been commercial and free of government interference. That is what distinguishes our media system from every other, nearly every other country in the world.
What thoughts about all of this?
My thoughts are that putting a female congresswoman out to respond to the president's State of the Union isn't going to paper over decades of public policies that have been disastrous for women.
American farms aren't what they were. We have this idea of these sort of lily-white pastoral farms. And when the Fair Labor Standards Act passed in 1938, it exempted farms because that was the case. You had these family-run farms. Nowadays, and since 1950s and 60s, they've been corporate-owned. You have these factory farms that are employing thousands of people.
I absolutely agree that in these behind closed doors, people should have more latitude in saying different things. If this was said to the president, about the president, this is absolutely newsworthy. Dick Durbin should be telling us about it. CNN should be reporting on it. It's hideous to think about.
Yes, is America reluctant to hold us accountable
question.
For these actions?
He telegraphed it's going to be unbelievably small. Then he had to walk that back.
He didn't telegraph. John. He was being honest with the American people. The American people want to know what to expect.
Then let's go look at the case study. Massachusetts, my home state, that, you know, the doctor said that there were only 127 or some odd people in Delaware, and that was a problem. We only had 123 in the state of Massachusetts in the first month, and now this has been deemed a success. It does absolutely depend on young people enrolling. Are they enrolling at the numbers the administration would like? Absolutely not. But we know young people, sometimes they can wait till the last minute.
Right now I'm at an academic conference here in Washington, D.C. with a lot of professors that study media and study journalism. And the big sort of meme that's going around here is a collapse of context.
One thing we need to reform first is this kind of culture of personal attacks, this politics of personal destruction.
And there's no question that people like a rough and tumble politician, that people like a politician who is candid, who speaks, you know, truth to power, as unvarnished. If you can mix that with a real strong sense of ethics, a real strong sense of virtue in the way you conduct your business.
I mean, well, what is he doing? I mean, explain that to me, Mark.
Congressman Ryan doesn't believe what he's saying. You saw that in the interview right now. He's laughing it off a little bit. He's shrugging it off. Let's think about this, though. What do all these guys have in common, whether it's Ted Cruz, Rand Paul, Paul Ryan? Each of these is trying to pounce on an increasingly right-wing Republican base because each of them has an eye toward 2016.